pretty sure you know what the word is by now, what we're going to be going over in class today. Joshua, what do you think the word is?
Teamwork.
Teamwork. Excellent. I don't know if you've heard any of your teachers say this yet, but teamwork, it really does make that dream work. And so, the question that we're going to be discussing with our classmates and as a class, what does teamwork mean to you? I want you to think about that for a second. What does teamwork mean to you? I've been hearing stories from the other colleagues that PE has not been going over too well. Sportsmanship needs to be looked at again. You know, it's a game. We're supposed to help each other out. Blake, go ahead and answer this question for us. What does teamwork mean to you?
I think a team is where a group of people come together, and teamwork is when they work together like a team.
Very good. I like how you took that compound word and you used it in your description to tell us team and work and why they go together. Let me call on someone else. Mila, in the back, we haven't heard too much from you. Would you like to tell us what teamwork means to you? No, please, please. There is no wrong answer at all. You can speak freely about what you think. Hey, come on, class. You know, we help our classmates out. All right, so what we're going to go on to now, talking about teamwork, is...
Hi, is this Miss Vanderburg?
Hi.
Hi, Miss Vanderburg. My name is Miss Gardner, and I'm Mila's ELD teacher over at Superfragilistic Expialidocious High School. And I'm contacting you in regards to Mila's participation at school. I'm noticing she's having some difficulties with her peers and refusing to participate in classroom speaking activities. You know, she does written work, but the stuff she turns in, it's excellent work. She does really good work.
That's good.
And I can't seem to get her to communicate that knowledge verbally during class time. Is she shy at home or?
Oh my gosh, no. She talks all the time. She doesn't really talk to the neighbor kids, but at home, if you come to our house, she'll talk your ear off.
Really?
But yeah, but at home, she speaks perfect English, but and she started learning in Holland at age 5.
Oh wow, that is really awesome. I didn't know that. Do you have any ideas to help me, to help her open up in class and be more comfortable speaking in class?
Yeah, maybe have her talk about her culture. She really likes talking about herself, and maybe like the stuff that she likes, and that might help her open up.
Oh, I really like that. You're giving me an excellent idea right now. Perhaps sharing a culture bag, and she can, what you just said, share out her background, her past, and where she's from. I'm sure the kids would love that. I don't think they've met anyone from Holland yet.
Okay.
That is really awesome. What kind of English did she learn when she was in Holland, if you don't mind me asking?
She learned British English back home, so she's really uncomfortable with what you guys call American slang, I guess, is what
I
you guys
see,
call it.
I see. So she's more comfortable with British English, I see.
Yes.
Interesting. Thank you so much for your help, Ms. Vanderburg. Did you have any questions for me?
No, I just hope that if, hopefully those things can work, and if not, maybe just give me a call back, or maybe the three of us can meet together and talk about it so that she opens up, because she can talk, and she really likes to talk, so we need her to start participating.
I'm so happy to hear that. You're giving me some great ideas I can work with, and hopefully we can really get Mila out of her shell and start talking in class with her peers. Thank you so much, Ms. Vanderburg, for your time.
Oh, great.
You
no,
questions?
Yes,
please
thank
you.
Definitely, call me too.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, bye-bye.
Awesome. So a bunch of our classmates went earlier today and they showed us our cultural bag. I really like this assignment that we're doing. You are the teacher. I want to learn about you. And who we have to learn now today is Mila. It's your turn. Can you please stand up and come on up and show us your cultural bag? We'd love to learn about you.
The first thing in my bag. Tennis ball, because back home I play tennis a lot with my dad, and it's one of my favorite sports. I like all sports, though, really. And the other thing in my bag is a book, because I really love to read, especially books about pedagogy.
All right, so I think we're just about done studying our American slang Kim charts. We finished reviewing them, and now we're going to put it to the test and play this slang bingo. So if you can go ahead and put away your Kim in charge of green will get ready for our slam bingo. Now, on our slam bingo, it has a bunch of the American slang terms. One of them, it says, face the music. Now, face the music might mean, say I took Rebecca's lunch or lunch money, or I took her sweater, or I did something, and she comes and asks me, I tell her, no, I didn't do it, I have no idea. She's asking the whole class, where's my stuff? You know, at some point, I'm gonna have to come out and face the music. And so I eventually come and I say, you know, Rebecca, I accidentally did take your stuff, and I face the music. And so that's some one of those terms would mean. So I'm gonna go ahead and pass it out. Go ahead and take a look at some of the sayings we have on there. Get familiarize yourself. You might already know some. Go ahead and do that. Is there any that stands out to you? Any that you know? You're like, I know that. My mom says it all the time. Yes, Leo, is there any?
Hang in there.
Hang in there. Awesome. And what does that mean to you?
It means don't give up.
I like it. Does anyone else have any examples?
Yes, Rebecca.
Give me five.
Give me five. Awesome. And how do you interpret or see that?
That's like, hold on, I need to do something real quick.
Okay, I like that. Give me five.
I like that a lot.
Anyone else have any sayings that they see on the bingo card that stands out to them they'd love to share? Yes, Mila.
What does break a leg mean?
Uh-huh, break a leg. That's a good one. It's a funny one, and we say it, but we never mean it. So, Mila, you love sports, right? And you play tennis with your dad. So you're going to go and play tennis with your dad this weekend. You go ahead and you tell me, Leah, and Rebecca that. I'm going to say, Mila, break a leg, which in other words means have fun. Have a great time. You're going to have so much fun that we don't want you to break a leg, but you should be having that much fun. Is that